South Africa. It's a nation of tremendous untapped potential with millions of young people looking to work. It's also a place with a long and brutal history, with soaring public debt, grim public services, and yawning inequality. Though the size of South Africa's black middle class has more than doubled, by some measures, the nation is worse off now than it was a decade ago. Let's look at those three main challenges in South Africa today. First, the economy. South Africa enjoyed boom times. For the gold, platinum, diamonds, and coal it produced and exported. Then the global financial crisis hit in 2008. Demand for all those things slowed, and the nation's economy still hasn't recovered. Second, corruption. Former President Jacob Zuma took it to another level, and he's faced nearly 800 separate counts of corruption charges. That kind of thing usually puts the brakes on any sort of economic reform. Third, apartheid's legacy. The dusty, sprawling townships and poor villages where many black South Africans still live continue to keep people at a distance from the chance to learn and work. What's their future? What happens when their frustrations boil over? How will the African National Congress, once the beating heart of resistance to opposition, respond the next time its dominance is tested? Will this time be different? National elections are on the calendar, and South Africans aren't the only ones paying attention.